and you're going to come straight ahead. And
mammograms can tell you a lot, but when it comes to what you've inherited, you can get answers from genetic testing.
One of the things that we try to do in our questionnaires before we do the procedure is to ask them if they've been tested. A lot of times they don't even know what that is, so it gives us an opportunity to inform them about the BRCA1 and BRCA2 gene mutation testing that they can do.
Getting tested for BRCA1 and BRCA2 will tell you if you've inherited an increased risk for breast and ovarian cancer.
BRCA itself, BRCA, is actually a protein.
Dr. Richard Rosenfield says that knowledge gives patients options.
In our female patients, breast cancer can happen in as many as 1 in 8 women in the course of their lifetime. But women that have the BRCA mutation can have up to a 5 times increased risk of getting breast cancer.
When it comes to understanding your risk, here's what you can do. First, get educated. Learn about genetic tests. There are even home kits now. Next, get tested. If you have a positive result, you can meet with a genetic specialist for counseling to understand your options. And of course, keep getting your routine breast screenings. If you do test positive for BRCA1 or BRCA2,
we'll do the exact same testing for you as we do for anybody.
I'm gonna take you back for your MRI.
But the indication of that will give the doctor kind of a heads up that you are a much higher risk category.
You may get extra screenings, like breast MRI, in addition to your mammograms. Some patients with BRCA1 or BRCA2 rotate between breast mammograms and breast MRIs every 6 months.
How you doing?
The additional screenings give you valuable information to help catch cancer early.
All right, you did great.
I'm grateful that we have this information for them so that they can kind of jump ahead and be more proactive in their own health.